in the Pringle, but what a really good start to proceedings here. So here are Australia.
Up against the Netherlands. Hershner and Karnis against McCulloch and Mears. And Mears in the black helmet will lead off for Carly McCulloch.
Done.
It'll be Hershner for Willie Karnis, who's the star individual sprinter for the Dutch.
They didn't make the best of starts, did the Dutch. They'll want to be really fighting hard here because Australia are well up here.
We need to post the time. It is rider number 53, Carly McCulloch, because she needs the quickest time to get into the gold medal right off. She's humming around the track. Will it be quick enough? She's into the front straight. She'll beat the Dutch, but will it be quick enough? 32.806 for Australia. 33.090 for the Dutch.
Well, Hichenau came back well in the second half of that race, but it just wasn't enough. They'd not got the best of starts, and in fact Hichenau almost got over the top of Karnis, such as the battling start that she had. But Anna Mears getting the Australians off to a good start. Just not enough for the Netherlands. 0.284 second off the time posted by Mears and McCulloch of 32.806. They came back just a hundredth of a second in that back end.
Quicker than the qualifying time of 32.82. And the Dutch, a reasonably good ride for them as well, but it won't be good enough to get into the medal race. And it's France versus Germany, and the top eight will go off, and these are some of the big hitters, the reigning world champions, Germany, Vogel and Velter. Germany 32.630 in qualifying, behind China's 32.447, but they had their issues. We know Velter is a very, very rapid finisher. Sandy Clare and Virginie Quiff of France. There they are. Being consistent at the World Championships. Can they produce a stellar performance? They were fifth at the World Titles in 2010. Of course, the Germans, the reigning champions of the world after Miriam Velter had that horrific accident back in 2009 when she was lucky to stay alive, and she's back as a world champion and world record holder. It's France versus Germany. Let's see the start. It's clean by both nations. The French pushing a big gear. Germany off to a good start, but a little bit of distance between the first and second rider for France. Let's see the time split. It's France down, Germany in front, so they may have tidied up their act from qualifying, Germany. And Velter will take the baton now, and rider 121, it's Christina Vogel. In fact, they've changed their order, and Vogel will bring it home for Germany. So somewhat of a surprise in the order, but the Germans will go through 32.701, and that combines just under the Australian time of 32.806. So that's an excellent time posted by Germany. Of course, their world record 32.549 from Melbourne earlier this year, but that may be good enough to get them into a gold medal write-off.
Well, the Germans are the team to beat if you were to go on the World Championships. They were the surprise gold medalists there, but they're showing here that they are going to be very much in the mix here. The French, well, Virginie Kouf had plenty to do when she took over from Sandy Clare, and just not enough in the legs to drive it home over a second down on Germany.
32.701, Australia 32.806. 33.707 for
France.
France.
Yeah. Union flag flying again because Great Britain are out on the track.
Great Britain versus Ukraine. So really, they've got to take their opponents out of the equation here and stay firm to their belief, because we saw Victoria Pendleton come up with an amazing second leg in qualifying.
She was amazingly strong in the qualifying after a tidy start by Jessica Varnish. They set or broke the world record, which was broken the very next heat by the Chinese.
Great Britain recorded 32.526. Of course, they're the former world record holders at this track earlier this year. And can Varnish set it up for Victoria Pendleton? Ukraine on time and pedigree. Won't be in the contest, you wouldn't think. And very ragged in the first change. The Brits well in front. The second rider from Ukraine losing contact with her partner. And the British hand over to Victoria Pendleton. It is Queen Victoria. Rider 110. Already the Olympic champion in the sprint 4 years ago. Can she drive Britain to a gold medal right off? 32.567. And they've done it. At the moment, they're into the gold medal write-off. And a very, very impressive display indeed by Pendleton and Jess Varnish.
Well, you just get the feeling that they're pleased, but not delighted. They've got themselves into the gold medal write-off as it stands now. China against Venezuela still to come, but Varnish getting them off to a really good start. Huge effort. Driving that massive gear. And Victoria Pendleton, well, again, bringing it home for Great Britain. Not the world record time. You see, they're not the absolute delight and excitement for Great Britain.
Reason being, because China scorched around the boards at 32.447 to set that new world record. So it's always nervous times when you've got a nation that is floating out there. At the moment, it's Great Britain. 32.567. Other commissaires looking at the transition zone. You always get nervous if you're a coach looking at the commissaires viewing any sort of video. It's flick the eyebrows up.
Yeah.
And there's a transition zone in men's and women's team sprinting. If you leave that zone and you transition, you can be disqualified. And the UCI commissaire is speaking to his colleagues, so whether that's a decision that's about to be made based on what they've seen, well, we'll soon find out.
And who is it? That is the key. He's called one of the commissaires over to have another look. Confirmation of that time for Great Britain, 32.567.
So as it stands, Britain are the fastest, 32.567. Germany, 32.7701. Australia at third, France fourth, with China to come, who are the current world record holders. The British coach is over there,
Brailsford's gone across there, I think.
Yep. The sprint coach.
So it's Great Britain they're looking at. Well, there might be a problem here.
This British sprint coach, Ian Dyke. Dave Brailsford. He's also the head of the program, and he's looking at
it's a tense moment, this, for Great Britain. It really is. This could be a really disastrous situation for Great Britain, Victoria Pendleton and Jess Varnish. The commissaires are having a conversation. Dale Brailsford wanted to listen in, and I don't know if it's going to be good news. Meanwhile, China, who set the fastest time in qualifying,
32.447. Up against Venezuela, who won't be anywhere near that time. China, Gong Jiji and Guo Shuang, their combination, absolutely scintillating in qualifying. You saw them pump themselves up before the heat to set that fastest time and a new world record. And it's a clean start, although she went a little bit towards the blue section of the track. Venezuela go high on the track. China pushing an enormous gear. It'll be Gong Jinji. And they're already up by 0.8 of a second, but that is not a reflection on how will things go. 32.567 is the time to beat. China through that first break with some work to do. It is Gao Shuang, the powerhouse sprinter, a veteran of this Chinese team. Can she bring it home? 32.567 is the time. It's going to be under it. A new world record. 32.422. China have the chance for Olympic gold in the inaugural team sprint for women. What a ride. Two consecutive world records by Gong Jinji and Guo Shuang.
Amazing ride by China. So consistent. And they've shown that they are going to be the team to beat here, depending on who they're going to ride against still. Because there appears to be a problem with in the Great Britain qualification. Meanwhile, Gong Jinji and Guo Shuangwa have put in the ride of the night thus far. A new world record, second time they've improved on the world record. And it's now 32.422.
And there's the experienced man Daniel Morlon for so long with the French structure, now with China. And no wonder they're going so well.
Yeah, he's doing a great job.
He's got plenty of experience, a former world champion. And a new world record, 32.422. That is just exceptional sprinting by the Chinese pair.
Well, Venezuela outside their qualifying time at 32.340. So they'll be disappointed with their ride in the first round. Lareal, Daniela Lareal in her seventh Olympics. That's bringing it home there for them. But they were never in that up against the world record holders. Air of tension around the velodrome at the moment. As we reflect on the round of racing now in the women's team sprint.
As it stands, China will race Great Britain for the gold medal. But that is to be confirmed because the commissaires are judging Britain's first round, where they posted a time of 32.567. Germany was behind Britain, so if the results stand, it means that China will face Great Britain for the gold and Germany up against Australia for the bronze medal. That's still to be confirmed, and that's exactly why track sprinting's such an explosive and exciting form of cycling, because you bring the officials and technique and rules into play, and Germany will face Australia for the bronze medal, which means that China, as it stands, will race Great Britain. But again, we'll just confirm that when it comes through. Seems to be animated conversation between Team GB and the chief commissaire.
Doesn't look good news, does it?
Well, no, that's been amended. So Germany will face Australia in the women's team sprint